Hi everybody, 11 Institute welcomes all the students of standard 9th to the subject science. We have been discussing chapter number 6 and today we are in the video lecture number 6 or part 6 of the chapter tissues. So in tissues, in this chapter basically we have to discuss plant tissues and animal tissues. We have already discussed about plant tissues. We have taken a short objective type of test and from today we will move towards animal tissues. Right, so in animals, as usual, we also know that human beings are also grouped as animals. So we will generally talk about us or what type of tissues are present in animals or what type of tissues are present in humans. We will revolve and rotate around hint that what type of body tissues do we possess. Right, so let us move ahead and first see the introductory part that is given in the textbook. Some examples about the human tissues that we feel. Right, so let us read. When we breathe, we actually feel the movement of our chest. Right, that is fine. When we breathe, we feel the movement of our chest. Right? Right. So just think, right, or if you can't understand, just try to breathe now while watching this video. Just breathe, right? Try to inhale and then exhale, right? You can see your body is moving. When you inhale, when you exhale, the part of the chest, the torso, is moving. It is growing, it is declining, it is steeping, right? How does this movement occur? Which type of cells are responsible for this body, for this movement? Right, how do these body parts move? They move due to the presence of muscles. Right, whatever type of movement that is done by our body, either that may be voluntary or involuntary. Voluntary in the sense that apne apni jaate kariye, આપણી મરજીથી કરીએ. ફોર એક્ઝામ્પલ, તમારે તમારો હાથ આગળ લઈ જવો છે, પાછળ લઈ જવો છે, એ તમારી પોતાની મરજીથી મૂવમેન્ટ થાય છે, તો એ વોલન્ટરી મસલ્સ છે. અમુક મૂવમેન્ટ ઇનવોલન્ટરી છે. તમે શ્વાસ લ્યો છો ત્યારે તમારી રીતના શ્વાસ નહીં લેતા, શ્વાસ તમે ટ્રાય ન કરો ત્યારે ઓટોમેટિક બી આપણું બોડી લે જ છે. તો એટ ધેટ ટાઈમ ધ મૂવમેન્ટ ઇઝ ઓટોમેટિક એન્ડ દેટ ઇઝ ઓલ્સો ડન બાય મસલ્સ, જે ઇનવોલન્ટરી છે. Right, but ultimately all such movements are due to the presence of muscles. So muscle or one type of tissue which is present in animals is known as muscular tissue, right? Muscular tissue. Sure, I hope this is clear to you. For this movement, we have specialized cells called muscle cells, right? The contraction and relaxation of these cells result in movement. So ultimately, who is responsible for movement? Muscle cells. The muscle cells are responsible for movement. Fine. So muscles are one type of tissues present in animals. During breathing, we inhale oxygen. Each and every one of us knows this. Where does this oxygen go? Right. When you inhale oxygen, where does this oxygen go? Goes, it is absorbed in the lungs. And then it is transported to the body cells through blood. Right, so when you inhale oxygen through the nostrils, that oxygen goes to lungs. From lungs, this oxygen goes to blood. And then blood transports oxygen to different body parts. Transports oxygen to different body parts, right? Because each and every cell ultimately requires oxygen. Fine. So now this function of transportation is performed by a specific group of cells that is known as blood. So now the way in which muscle was responsible for movement of our body, in the same way when we want to transport substances, here there is example of oxygen, sometimes we want to transfer hormones, sometimes we want to transport carbon dioxide. whenever I want to transport something, that will be done by blood. So blood is one type of connective tissue. It connects the body. Sir, connect kevi ritna thiyu? Tame jo, we are inhaling oxygen from nose, but it is distributed to all the parts of body. So that is a type of connection, right? So blood is the connective tissue. Moving ahead. Why do cells need oxygen? Samjhai diyu bhai, oxygen is inhaled, then this inhaled oxygen goes to lungs, from lungs it goes to blood, and from blood it goes to cells. But why cells need oxygen? We know this very well, right? We know this very well. In previous chapter we have discussed a term like this, cellular respiration. Cellular respiration. Let me make you clear over here. Suppose this is a particular cell. In cell, I am having the mitochondria over here. Now, suppose I am having oxygen. The oxygen goes to lungs. From lungs, it goes to blood. And from blood, this oxygen moves inside the cell. In cell, this oxygen is used by mitochondria. The mitochondria will generate ATP from it, and at the same time, instead of oxygen, carbon dioxide is produced inside the cell, and this carbon dioxide will move out. Now, mitochondria, in order to generate ATP, undergo several chemical reactions, and for those chemical reactions, oxygen is necessary. If oxygen is not there, mitochondria will not be able to generate enough amount of energy in the form of ATP. For this reason, oxygen is required by cells. And who carries the oxygen to the cells? Blood. So definitely blood is a very important connective tissue. Right? Blood flows and carries various substances from one part of the body to the other. For example, it carries oxygen and food to all the cells. It carries oxygen and food to all the cell. It also collects the waste from all the parts of body and carries them to liver and kidney for disposal, right? It carries both the type of substances. So suppose I am having a cell, and suppose I am having some good substances like the food, like oxygen. They are carried to the cell by blood. Cell will use this food. Cell will use this oxygen. It will perform its functions, and after performing the functions, the cell will generate waste materials, and these waste materials are again transported by the blood for proper disposal. Disposal means to remove from the body. Now, to remove such waste from the body, we are having different organs like kidney and liver, right, which will remove the waste from our body. So ultimately, if blood is not there, cell will not be able to get these good substances or necessary substances, and cell will not be able to remove this waste substances if blood was not there. So this is the importance of blood in our body. There are more functions by blood. We are for now seeing the main function, which is transportation. Right? Let us move ahead. See, this is blood. Right? This is animated feeder of blood. You can see there is a type of fluid in it, which is plasma, and there are many different types of cells, right? There is red blood cell, there is white blood cell, there is platelet, right? There are different types of cells in it, three different types of cells actually, right? Red blood cells, white blood cells, and platelets. There are many more cells, like macrophages are there, then there are different types of white blood cells like acidophils, basophils, etc. But for now, you have to remember these three names: red blood cells, white blood cells, and platelets. Right, and there is a plasma. Sure, let us move ahead. This is the image of a muscular tissue. You can see there are many cells and such bundles are over there. These muscular tissues are responsible for the movement in our body. Fine. So this is the introductory part of the animal tissues, and we have seen two examples: blood, muscles. On the basis of the function they perform, we can think of different types of animal tissues, and we have four different types of animal tissues. Number one, epithelial tissue. Number two, connective tissue. Number three, muscular tissue. And number four, nervous tissue. These are the four different types of tissues that animals have: epithelial tissue, connective tissue, muscular tissue, nervous tissue. Let me give you a short overview. The main function that will be performed by epithelial tissue is protection. And for protection, it will be used as covering. This is not looking good. I will write this in a better manner. So let us erase this. Yes. And now we will again try to write. The main function that is performed by epithelial tissues is protection. Right. Protection. And for protection, it will generally be used as covering, either on the inner part of the body or on the outer part of the body. Means, if I say that there is an example of skin, then the outermost layer of skin is nothing but the epithelial tissue, because it is used for protection and for covering. So based upon the function, these cells will have a specific design or a specific structure. Then there will be some more functions also performed, but their primary function, their main function of any epithelial tissue is protection and covering. Secondly, we are having connective tissue, and their main function will be joining the body as a whole to provide a network system inside the body, right? Connection each and everywhere. Transportation will be their function. There are various roles for connective tissue. Muscular tissues, definitely they are responsible for movement. And movement are of two types: voluntary and involuntary. Right, voluntary and involuntary. And last one we are having is nervous tissue. You know, parts of the body like brain, spinal cord, where thinking is involved, where decision making is involved. Such parts of the body like brain and spinal cord are made up of nothing but the nervous tissues. So now let us see the classification of the animal tissues, right? But before that, we can see where are these tissues located, right? Connective tissue, muscles, epithelial tissue, blood, bone tissue, fine, nervous tissue, each and everywhere its connection is there, adipose tissue, fat tissue, right? We can say adipose tissue, cartilage. These are the different examples of animal tissue that we are going to discuss in detail. Let us now see the classification of animal tissues. Now this is a very important topic. You should know this classification very well. It can be asked in exam also. Fine. Classification of plants was also animal. Classification of animal tissue is also important. Let us see. So we are having animal tissues, and as we have seen in the previous slide, that there are basically four types of animal tissues. The first one among them is epithelial tissue, right? Second is connective tissue. Third is muscular tissue. And fourth is nervous tissue. Right, epithelial tissue, connective tissue, muscular tissue, and nervous tissue. Now these are having subtypes. There are four types of epithelial tissues, then there are many more types of connective tissues, muscular tissue, and nervous tissue does not have any subtype. So this first one, epithelial tissue, the second one, connective tissue, and the third one, muscular tissue, have some subtypes, but nervous tissue does not have any subtype. So let us now further classify the epithelial tissue. The first one is simple squamous epithelial tissue. Just have to see the names for now. We will discuss each and every tissue in the detail. For now, you have to just see and remember the names. Simple squamous epithelial tissue. Then stratified squamous epithelial tissue. So both of them are squamous, but first one is simple, second one is stratified. Then we have columnar epithelial tissue. and that can be also ciliated and cuboidal epithelial tissue, which can be also glandular. These brackets are important to remember. You know, a question can be asked like this: which epithelial tissue is also known as ciliated epithelium? Is also known as ciliated epithelium. So our answer will be columnar epithelium. Right? Our answer will be columnar epithelium. Sure. In the same way, one more question can be asked: which epithelial tissue is known as glandular epithelium? In that case, our answer will be cuboidal epithelium. Cuboidal epithelium. I hope this is clear to you. Fine. See, all the columnar epithelial tissue cannot be ciliated. They can be sometimes ciliated. All the cuboidal epithelial tissue cannot be glandular. They can be sometimes glandular. Right, we will discuss them in detail. But epithelial tissue is having four more subtypes: simple, stratified, columnar epithelial, and cuboidal epithelium. Depending upon the type of cells, their functions, we are having four more epithelial tissues. But their common function will be protection. Their common function will be protection or covering. This will be their common function. Let us move ahead. Connective tissue, first example is blood. Then we are having bone. Then we are having areolar tissue. Then we are having adipose tissue. Right. Now, bone is a fluid. Sorry, blood is a fluid connective tissue. Right. It is a type of fluid. These are proper connective tissues. Right, this is a solid or hard connective tissue, but such classification is not given in our textbook. Right, actually connective tissue is having different types: connective tissue proper, fluid connective tissue, solid connective tissue. Right, but in your textbook there are no such classifications given. There are just four examples given over here: blood, bone, areolar tissue, and adipose tissue. Right, and you just simply have to remember the names, because when you give exams, when you attempt exams, you have to write the answers based upon your textbook. Definitely gain the extra knowledge, definitely gain some understanding, right, a practical understanding. But as far as the exams are concerned, when you are going to write the answers, those should be only and only according to the textbook. You will not write anything that is not given in the textbook, right? Be clear about it. So there are four examples of connective tissue given in our textbook. Then we have muscular tissue, striated muscle, smooth muscle, and cardiac muscle. See, striated muscle is also known as voluntary muscle, and smooth muscle is also known as involuntary muscle. Right, striated muscle is also known as voluntary muscle. Smooth muscle is also known as involuntary muscle. And last one is known as cardiac muscle, which is generally found in heart. You know, heart moves continuously throughout the life. From our birth till death, that is the organ which moves continuously 24/7, irrespective of the condition. It will continuously pump the blood to different parts of body. It will continuously contract and relax. And such continuous movement is performed by a special tissue, and that is our cardiac muscle, which is only present in heart and related organs. Right. Apart from that, we are having striated muscles. They are known as voluntary. Smooth muscles, they are known as involuntary, based upon the type of functions performed by them. And the fourth one that we have is the nervous tissue. And nervous tissue is made up of cells known as nerve cells, which are better known as neurons. And neurons are single type. There are no other differences in different types of neurons. Right. So in nervous tissue, there is no special type. It is single. It is not classified further. So this is the classification of animal tissues, and you have to remember it very well. In exam, this same chart can be asked, but here smooth muscle will not be written. There will be a blank over here. So you have to fill in the blanks that yes, this is a smooth muscle. Right, there will be a blank given over here and you have to write that yes, columnar epithelial tissue is also there. Fine. So such questions can be asked. So now I request you to please pause the video and write this down in your CW. Please pause the video and write this down in your CW. Alright, so let us now start with the first tissue, the epithelial tissue. We will see the introduction of epithelial tissue in today's video lecture. So let us move ahead. Yes, so let us begin with the introduction of animal tissues. The covering or protective tissues in animal body are epithelial tissues. I have told this you in the start itself, at the start itself, that the covering or the protective tissues in the human body are epithelial tissues. Wherever you want to cover something, wherever you want to protect the internal organs of the body, that organ or that part will be covered by epithelial cells or epithelial tissues. Location where they are found. See now, before moving ahead, whenever we will discuss any type of animal tissues, we will try to focus on three aspects. Right, the first aspect is location. Where such a tissue or such group of cells is found, based upon their location, they will have some special structure. Right. Now, you can consider, suppose there are some cells in our brain and suppose there are some cells in our skin. Do you think both have same role? No. The cells that are present on the surface of the skin have different role. The cells those are present inside the brain have different role. So their locations are different. And based upon their different locations, they will be having different structure. And due to this, that difference in the structure, they will have different function to perform. Or different role to perform, right? Their function or role will be different. Sure. So what we will try to do is the information that is given in the textbook, we will divide them into three parts. We will see the location, we will see the structure, and we will see the function and role. At times it will happen that sometimes the structure is not explained in the textbook, sometimes the function is not explained in the textbook, so we will omit. But primarily we will try to classify the data into this. We will discuss about the location, we will discuss about the structure, and we will discuss about the function or role. So let us now see the location of the epithelial tissue. Where in the body can you find them? See, you can find the epithelial tissue in the skin, the lining of mouth, right? Mouth, apnu je modu che eni andar nu part che wo soft che. That outer covering is made up of the epithelial tissue, the lining of blood vessels. Blood vessels are, tame sambhalelu hase, arteries, veins, capillaries. These are blood vessels. This is a network of tubules that carry the blood, right? Blood no highway che. Blood ek jagya thi biji jagya body ni andar blood vessels thi transfer thai che. Lung alveoli. Alveoli are small bed-like structures present in the lung. In outer surface upar bhi epithelial tissue hoi che. And in the kidney tubules also they are made up of epithelial tissue. So epithelial tissue can be found in skin, inside the mouth, in the lining of blood vessels, alveoli and kidney tubules. These are some examples. There are many more examples, but these are some 4 to 5 examples given in our textbook. Structure, right? Regardless of the type, all the epithelium is usually separated from the underlying tissue by an extracellular fibrous basement membrane. Right, regardless of the type means there are 4 types of epithelial tissue. Right, simple, stratified, squamous, columnar, cuboidal, but all these types are separated from the underlying tissue by an extracellular fibrous basement membrane. See, what happens is, suppose this is our hand, right? Suppose this is our hand and these are suppose our fingers. whatsoever. And this is the outermost layer, which is our skin. So now skin is made up of epithelial tissue like this. There are many cells like this. Now below the skin, there will be different types of cells, right? Here there will be bone. Then there will be blood. So now here there is blood, which is one type of tissue. Above that we are having epithelial tissue, which is another type of tissue. Between them there will be a basement membrane. What will be there? There will be a basement membrane which will separate the epithelial tissue from other tissues of the body. There will be a basement membrane. It will be more clear to you with the help of this image that we will see now. See, you can see these are four different types of epithelial tissue that we are going to discuss. They are having different shapes. But in each and every one of them, you can see this layer. You can see over here. Right? This layer is known as basement membrane, right? It is present over here. It is present over here also. It is present over here also. See this one. This layer, this darker layer, right? Not this one. This layer. This layer is known as basement membrane. It will separate your tissue from other tissues. Right, suppose below this there is blood, there are muscles, and above it there is epithelial tissue. So this layer separates our epithelial tissue from different tissues, and that layer is known as basement membrane. It is fibrous, right? There is more fiber like material inside it, and they will separate the two types of tissues. So all the epithelium, there will be a basement membrane in them, right? Epithelial tissues are tightly packed and form a continuous sheet. Definitely. Why they are tightly packed? See, suppose this is one epithelial cell, then there will be another epithelial cell, then there will be another epithelial cell. Why they are tightly packed? Because their function is protection. Now if suppose they are loosely packed like this, anything can move inside and outside. We don't want that. What we want is protection, and for protection they should be tightly packed, right? Almost similar to the epithelial tissues that we are seeing in plants. In plants also the epithelial tissue was, the cells were tightly packed and they form a continuous sheet, right? They have only a small amount of cementing material between them and almost no intercellular spaces. So then very clear idea is given to us that there are no intercellular spaces, because if there are intercellular spaces, then the substances will move inside and outside, and we don't want that. We want a protective barrier. You can see there is no space between the cells over here, right? No intercellular spaces in order to form a continuous sheet. Let us move ahead. What is the function or role? Covering. Epithelium covers most organs and cavities within the body. Organs barabar, bada organ ne cover kare chhe, but cavities within the body. Now what do we mean by cavities? Nose chhe bada pase, nak. No hoy to apna natta thiye bhai, barabar na. Now your nose is having nostril hole chhe, barabar na. Cavity chhe ne, eni andar nu je aakho part chhe, that is covered with a particular type of skin. Right, so in apne shu kahiye cavity. That cavity is made up of epithelium. Je andar ni side nu covering chhe, tya epithelium nu covering hase. Evi j ritna apno ear chhe, tya bhi ek cavity pade chhe. So all such body cavities are, their outer most layer is made up of the epithelium. Fine. It forms a barrier to keep different body systems separate, right? It forms a barrier. Suppose apni skin na hoy, just think for 2 minutes, ke jo apni skin na hoy to directly apno muscle, blood, nervous tissue badhu visible hoy. Suppose apni chamdi hoy bahar ni, skin e hoy j nahi, to apno bone che, muscle che, blood che, e badhu yam bahar apanne rahadtu dekhay. Have badhu vastu mix thai jay na chale na, e badhane ek bija thi separate karva mate there should be a barrier between them, right? And that barrier is formed by epithelium. Anything entering or leaving the body must cross at least one layer of epithelium. That is final. कोई पण वस्तु ने body ની અંદર લઈ જાવી છે or body ની બહાર લઈ જાવી છે તો એને definitely epithelium નો એક layer તો cross કરવો જ પડશે, because body ની surrounding માં બહાર અને અંદર each and every outer part will be covered with the epithelium. As a result, the permeability of cells of various epithelia play an important role in regulating the exchange of materials between the body and the external environment, and also between the different parts of body. Have I understood? Necessary. રાઈટ, માની લ્યો આ એક એપિથેલિયમ નો લેયર છે. સપોઝ આ માની લઈએ આપણે આ એક એપિથેલિયમ નો લેયર છે. નાઉ ધીસ ઇઝ સપોઝ ધ આઉટર પાર્ટ ઓર આઉટસાઇડ ધી બોડી, એન્ડ ધીસ ઇઝ સપોઝ ધ પાર્ટ ઇનસાઇડ ધ બોડી. નાઉ ઇફ સમથિંગ વોન્ટ્સ ટુ મૂવ ફ્રોમ આઉટસાઇડ ટુ ઇનસાઇડ, ઓર ઇફ સમથિંગ વોન્ટ્સ ટુ મૂવ ફ્રોમ ઇનસાઇડ ટુ આઉટસાઇડ, ધેન ઇટ વિલ ડેફિનેટલી હેવ ટુ ક્રોસ ધીસ લેયર. કોઈ પણ વસ્તુ બહારથી અંદર લઈ જવી છે ઓર અંદરથી બહાર લઈ જવી છે તો એને આ લેયર ક્રોસ કરવો પડશે. તો આ લેયરના જે સેલ્સ છે રાઈટ, એની પરમિયાબિલિટી બહુ જ ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ બની જાય છે. શું ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ બની જાય છે? Permeability of these cells becomes very important. Why it becomes important? Right? What do you mean by permeability? Everything cannot move in and everything cannot move out. Only things that will move out will be chosen by these cells. બધી વસ્તુને અંદર નહીં આવવા દે, બધી વસ્તુને બહાર નહીં આવવા દે. તો વસ્તુ અંદર તે બહાર, કઈ વસ્તુ અંદર જશે, કઈ વસ્તુ બહાર જશે, કઈ નહીં જાય, એ કોની ઉપર ડિપેન્ડ કરે છે? Permeability of these cells. It will be an important factor in deciding what goes inside and what goes outside and what remains inside and what remains outside. Similarly, such epithelia is present between different parts of the body also. Suppose aya body no koi first part che ane aya body no koi bijo part che ane vachche aya epithelium che. હવે અહીંયાથી કોઈ વસ્તુ અહીંયા લઈ જવી છે તો એને એપિથેલિયમ ક્રોસ કરવું પડશે. પણ એ વસ્તુ અહીંયાથી અહીંયા જશે કે નહીં એ કોની ઉપર ડિપેન્ડ કરે છે? એપિથેલિયમની પરમિયાબિલિટી ઉપર. કોની ઉપર? પરમિયાબિલિટી. જો એની પરમિયાબિલિટી સારી છે તો વસ્તુ અહીંયાથી ત્યાં જશે, જો એ પરમિએબલ નથી તો વસ્તુ અહીંયાથી અહીંયા નહીં જાય. ફાઇન. સો પરમિયાબિલિટી ઓફ ધ સેલ્સ ઓફ એપિથેલિયમ ઇઝ વેરી મચ ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ એસ્પેક્ટ. રાઈટ? પરમિયાબિલિટી ઓફ સેલ્સ ઓફ એપિથેલિયા play an important role in regulating the exchange of materials either within the body from one part to another part or inside the body and outside the body. So this is the common introduction of the epithelial tissue, right? And you can see in the image there are four different types of epithelial tissues. Squamous, you can see there are flat cells. Then stratified squamous, there are many cells arranged one above the another. Right, stratified, then there are columnar, again there is a single layer of cells but they are of column shape, and here the cells are of cube shape, so the name is cuboidal. Each and every one of them is having some different functions, some different features, which we will discuss in the next video lecture. For now, what we have seen is general location, structure and function of epithelial tissue. I request you to please pause the video and write this down in your CW. Right, and please keep in mind the main function that they have is covering. Right, covering, and for covering they will be tightly packed and forming a continuous sheet. I believe that this image will hinder the writing process over here, so I request you to please rewind the video, go 2 to 3 minutes back so that this might be visible to you, and then you can write this. Right, or in case you want to write that, I will just help you out. No, just rewind the video so that this image gets removed, and then you can write all such points. Fine. So please write this in your CW, and we will meet in the next video lecture. There is a small homework for you. You have to draw the chart of plant tissue and animal tissue. One time in rough book so that you can compare. Fine. Chart of plant tissue and animal tissue about their classification. Chart of classification of plant tissue and animal tissue. Fine. Please write that. I hope this is clear to you. Sure, this is your homework, and this portion written over here you have to write in your CW. So I end the video lecture over here. Thank you very much. We will now meet again in the next video lecture and discuss about the different types of epithelial tissues whose name we have seen today. Take very good care of yourselves. Goodbye.